हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, गुड मॉर्निंग. वेलकम टू माय चैनल मैथ्स विद पनिंद्रा. इन दिस एपिसोड वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ ट्रायंगल्स, सेकंड एक्सरसाइज रिलेटेड प्रॉब्लम्स एंड एग्जांपल्स. लेट अस हैव अ डिस्कशन. द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन हियर, इन ट्रायंगल एबीसी प्रूव दैट 1/r1 प्लस 1/r2 प्लस 1/r3 इक्वल टू 1/r. We learned in the previous session's formula, R1 value is delta by S minus A, R2 is delta by S minus B, R3 is delta by S minus C. So, but we have here the reciprocals in LHS. So, the reciprocals of R1, R2, R3, you have to write the formula. Now, consider LHS. 1/r1. Plus 1/r2 plus 1/r3, which is equal to 1/r1 value is delta by S minus A plus 1/r2 plus 1/r3. We know that denominator of a denominator, numerator. So it will becomes S minus A by delta plus S minus B by delta plus S minus C by delta. So in every term, delta take common in the denominator. So 1/delta S minus A plus S minus B plus S minus C. So after the reaching of this step, 1/delta into S plus S plus S is 3S and minus take common from ABC. So minus of A plus B plus C. We know that the perimeter of the triangle is A plus B plus C is equal to 2S. Therefore, in place of A plus B plus C, you have to write 2S. So 3S minus 2S. So A plus B plus C value is 2S. We have formula. So which is equal to 1/delta into S. We have relation delta is equal to SR. So since we have delta equal to S into R. So in place of S divided by SR, if we substitute S, S get cancelled. We will get 1/r, which is required RHS. Therefore, conclusion step. Even we can use as a standard result 1/r1 plus 1/r2 plus 1/r3 is equal to 1/r. Hence, proved. The next question, show that R into R1 into R2 into R3 equal to delta square. This result also you can remember as a standard result. Consider LHS. R into R1 into R2 into R3. Just now we wrote the formulas, na? R value is delta by S into R1 value is delta by S minus C, R2 is delta by S minus B, and R3 is delta by S minus C. We know that numerator delta into delta into delta into delta is delta power 4. We have formula delta equal to square root of S into S minus A into S minus B into S minus C. We have to do that squaring on both sides. We have formula. Since your place is not sufficient, actually here we have to write delta equal to square root of S into S minus A into S minus B into S minus C. Squaring on both sides, if we do that, delta square equal to S into S minus A into S minus B into S minus C. So now this value denominator will becomes delta square only, no? So we can cancel it, delta square times, which is equal to delta square, which is required RHS. Therefore, conclusion step, R into R1 into R2 into R3 is equal to delta square. You can utilize as a standard result. We'll move to the next question. The next question, in an equilateral triangle, find the value of small r by capital R, which is also important for 2 marks. Now consider small r divided by capital R. We know that formula, small r in terms of capital R and sine A, B, C. That also half angles. So small r equal to, we have formula 4 into capital R into sine A by 2, sine B by 2, sine C by 2 divided by capital R. Now capital R get cancelled. After that, since the triangle is an equilateral triangle, therefore A equal to B equal to C, which is equal to 60 degrees. So now 4 into sine 60 by 2, sine 60 by 2, sine 60 by 2, so which is equal to 4 into sine 30, sine 30, sine 30, so 4 into sine 30 whole cube, so 4 into sine 30 value is 1 by 2, 1 by 2 whole cube, which is equal to 4 by 2 cube is 8, which is equal to 1 by 2. Therefore, conclusion step, in an equilateral triangle, in an equilateral triangle, the value of small r by capital R is 1 by 2. We'll move to the next question. The next question, the perimeter of triangle ABC is 12 cm and its in radius is 1 cm. Then find the area of triangle. Area of triangle means delta. Perimeter means 2s is equal to 12. In radius is small r. So now given information, you have to write it. Given perimeter of triangle ABC, 2S is equal to 12. That implies that S is equal to 6. Given in radius, R is equal to 1 centimeter. After getting up the value of R and S, therefore, the area of triangle delta is equal to SR formula. So S value is 6 into R value is 1, which is equal to 6. Therefore, delta is equal to 6 square units. Area means square units, square centimeter here. We'll move to the next question. The next question, show that R into R1 equal to S minus B into S minus C. Whenever like this question they are asking, compulsory you have to depend on formulas. You should thorough the formulas. So for our convenience, dear students, I am writing the formula. R value, we have different formulas. We have small r equal to s minus a into tan a by 2, which is also equal to s minus b into tan b by 2, which is also equal to s minus c into tan c by 2. These are the formula for r. And r1 also we have different formulae. R1 also, that r1 value is r1 equal to s into tan a by 2, and the rest of the terms we can write in terms of s and cot. See here, s minus c into cot b by 2. Observe carefully, ma'am. S minus b into cot c by 2. So these formulas we are going to use in the proving of this result. Now consider LHS. R into R1. What is R value? R equal to, here answer in terms of S minus B, S minus C, no? So R I am taking in terms of S minus B. So R value is S minus B into tan B by 2. This is the value of R into R1 value. In terms of C I want, na? So you can take R1 value as S minus C into cot B by 2. So S minus C into cot B by 2. So which is equal to S minus B into S minus C tan B by 2 into cot B by 2. Cot B by 2 and tan B by 2 both are reciprocals. We know that tan theta into cot theta value equal to 1. So which is equal to S minus B into S minus C. If you know directly, you can write it. Otherwise, you can do like this way. You can cancel it. If you write like this, tan B by 2, you can cancel that both the values, which is equal to S minus B into S minus C, which is required RHS. Hence the result. The next question. In triangle ABC, delta equal to 6 square centimeter and S is equal to 1.5 centimeter. Find R, so radius they are asking, in radius. We know the relation between delta, S and R. We have, write it, ma, we have delta is equal to SR. From that, what values are required, R is going to calculate. So first, given that, given delta is equal to 6 square centimeter and S is equal to 1.5 centimeter. 1.5 can be written as 3 by 2 only, no? So now these values substitute or make as a subject from here. R is equal to delta by S. Delta is equal to 6 divided by S value is 3 by 2. Denominator of a denominator, numerator, 6 into 2 divided by 3, 3 1s are 3 2s are, 2 2s are 4. Therefore, the radius, in radius, small r equal to 4 centimeter. The next question, show that small r into r1 into cot a by 2 equal to delta. Again, we need formulae. So, first consider LHS. R into R1 into cot A by 2. Just now we discussed that delta is equal to SR. That means R is equal to delta by S. You write it R value in place of R, delta by S. And in the previous problem also, we wrote the value of R1. I'll show that. So here R1 value we wrote, no, S into tan A by 2. That we have to replace. R1 is equal to S into tan A by 2. So now R1 value is S into tan A by 2. This is the value of R1. Cot A by 2, as usual, we have to write it. This type of question is important for 2 marks. You remember that, dear students. S, S get cancelled. Delta into tan A by 2. Cot A by 2, you can write it as 1 by tan A by 2, no? Otherwise, if you know tan A by 2 into cot A by 2 is 1, directly you can write it. It's not a problem. So, which is equal to delta required RHS. Now, consider express A cos A plus B cos B plus C cos C by A plus B plus C in terms of capital R and small r. See, first, in place of A, small a, 2R sin A from sin rule. Small b, small c also same. Now, first consider the numerator A cos A plus B cos B plus C cos C divided by A plus B plus C. So, which is equal to, in place of A, 2R sin A into cos A plus in place of B, 2R sin B into cos B plus in place of C, 2R sin C into cos C divided by A plus B plus C is equal to 2S only, no? From perimeter of the triangle, we have that result. And which is equal to 2 sin A cos A, 2 sin B cos B, 2 sin C cos C. It will come sin 2A, sin 2B, sin 2C formally. So now you take common R, 2 sin A sin A cos A will become sin 2A plus 2 sin B sin C will become sin 2C, sin 2B plus 2 sin C cos C is sin 2C divided by 2S. After reaching of this step, we know that in previous sessions and transformations we discussed that the value of we have, since we have in triangle ABC sin 2A plus sin 2B plus sin 2C is equal to 4 sin A sin B sin C. You can write like this, no problem. You can write it directly. So after writing of the step, so the numerator value of this expression will become capital R into 4 sin A sin B sin C divided by 2S. So now, after that, I want the formula in terms of small r and capital R. Capital R anyway is there. So here 2 ones are, 2 twos are, you can cancel it. 2 ones are, 2 twos are. After that, we have formula. After that, we have formula 2R square into sin A, sin B, sin C is for delta. So now, to get 2R square, multiplying and dividing by capital R for this expression. So now, 2 into capital R is there. One more R I am multiplying. 2R square sin A, sin B, sin C divided by S into capital R. Why? Because here 1R we multiplied and dividing. We know that 2R square sin A sin B sin C is delta by delta value. Since we have delta equal to 2 r square sin a sin b sin c. You have to remember these number of formulas will be there in properties of triangles. You should learn thoroughly. So now the numerator value will becomes delta divided by sr. Now this is also can be written as delta by s into 1 by capital R. We know that delta by s is equal to delta by s is equal to small r. Delta by s is equal to, why? Because delta is equal to sr is the formula. From this, delta by s is equal to small r. So now in place of delta by s, you have to replace with small r. It will becomes, which is equal to small r into 1 by r, that is equal to small r by r. They are asking to prove the expression in terms of small r and capital R. We got it now, small r and capital R. Hence the result. We'll move to the next question. The next question. If A equal to 13, B equal to 14, C equal to 15, find R1. So whenever ABC values are there, you can calculate the perimeter of the triangle. So now, given ABC values. So given A equal to 13, B equal to 14, and C equal to 15. After getting the writing the values of this one, calculate 2s. 2s equal to 2s equal to a plus b plus c, which is equal to 13 plus 14 plus 15, which is equal to 42. See here, 9 plus 3 so 30, 42. So therefore 2s is equal to 42. That implies that S is equal to 2 2s are 2 1s are, so 21. S is equal to 21. After the value of S, to get R1, delta value is required. So delta value, how to get S minus A, S minus B, S minus C, calculate. So S minus A means 21 minus 13, which is equal to 8. S minus B, 21 minus 14, which is equal to 7. 21 minus 15, which is equal to 6. Now, S value, S minus A, S minus B, S minus C. So, we have the formula. Delta equal to square root of S into S minus A into S minus B into S minus C. So, which is equal to square root of 21 into S minus A value is 8 into S minus B value is 7 into S minus C value is 6. This is also can be written as 21 can be written as 7 into 3. 8 can be written as 2 into 4. 7 into 6 can be written as 2 into 3. So these values you can write it as square root of 7 square plus, so here 3 square, even 4 into 2 into 2, so total it is 16. 16 can be written as, you can write as 2 into 2, 4, 4 into 4, 4 square, that is better. 2 into 2, 4, now 4 into 4, 4 square. In the next step, 7 into 3 into 4, square root cancel, so which is equal to 7 into 3 into 4, that is delta value, which is equal to 7 3s are 21, 21 into 4, 4 is 84, therefore delta equal to 84. After getting the value of delta, we have formula R1 equal to, therefore R1 equal to delta by S minus A. Delta by S minus A. So which is equal to delta value is what? 84. S minus A value we got it in previous, S minus A is equal to 8. So 84 by 8, which is equal to 8 table, 8 tens are 80, remaining 4 will be there, point you can take and 0, 40 will be there, 8 5s are. So 10.5 units or centimeters, but they did not mention anything, no. So we can write as, we can leave it. R1 as some units. Here delta area means square units. The next question, if R into R2 equal to R1 into R3, then find angle B. So here we write the formulas of R, R1, R2, R3, then the problem is very easy. So now, given R into R2 equal to R1 into R3, that implies that R value is delta by S, R2 value is delta by S minus B, which is equal to R1 value is delta by S minus A, R3 value is delta by S minus C. So on both sides, delta, delta, delta cancel. What I am doing is, here S minus A into S minus C is there, no? I am taking into the numerator of LHS. So S minus, observe carefully, S minus A into S minus B, I'm taking S minus C, I'm taking here S minus A into S minus C divided by S into S minus B, which is equal to 1. From formulae, this value is equal to tan square B by 2. Whenever B is the denominator, it will be equal to tan square B by 2. So that implies that, that is the reason you should thorough the formula I have said. So tan square B by 2 is equal to 1. That implies tan B by 2 equal to 1. 1 can be written as tan pi by 4. Now comparing the angles, that implies that B by 2 equal to pi by 4. So 2 1s are, 2 2s are. So that implies that B equal to pi by 2. Therefore, the angle B equal to pi by 2 or 90 degrees. No need to write. We'll move to the next question. The next question. In triangle ABC, show that the sides of the triangle A comma B comma C are in AP if and only if R1, R2, R3 are in HP. HP means harmonic progression. Now consider if and only if they are giving, no, if and only if means first I am taking R1, R2, R3, R1, R2, R3 are in harmonic progression if and only if. Whenever the terms ABC are in harmonic progression, the reciprocals are in arithmetic progression only, no? So that implies that 1 by R1, 1 by R2, 1 by R3 are in AB. So if and only if, just now we discussed the values of R1, R2, R3. R1 value is delta by S minus A, but here 1 by R1, no? So S minus A by delta, S minus B by delta, S minus C by delta are in AP. In this, we observe that 1 by delta is common. We can cancel it in all the terms. That implies if and only if S minus A comma S minus B comma S minus C are also in AP. The common term we are cancelling, that's all. The common term we are cancelling. S minus A into S minus B into S minus C or in AP. We cancelled. So now, if and only if so in this also S is common in every term. So you can subtract S value from there. So common thing you can subtract, there is no change at all. So minus A, minus B, minus C are in AP. After that, multiplying each and every term with the minus, so it will becomes ABC are in AP. Hence the result. They are asking to prove, no, if and only if they are given. So here also if and only if condition, based on we prove that. Thank you dear students for watching my channel. We'll meet in the next video with a different problems in properties of triangles. Thank you all.